And an orbit plot shows the relative motion of the shaft center during one or multiple rotations of the shaft. And we've got an orbit plot displayed here on the right-hand side of the screen. And we'll kind of slowly step through how this plot is generated. But what you see here on the right is the motion of the center of the shaft through two cycles. So blue and red each denote one rotational cycle of our shaft. And this orbit plot gives us a lot of really interesting and useful information for diagnosing machine issues like unbalance, if there's misalignment or oil instabilities. Based on the shape of this orbit, diagnose, kind of like a doctor using a stethoscope, what is wrong with our machine. And we can also use it to determine things like the direction of precession of the rotor, which is also very important. We'll explain that on the next slide, but it basically uses the direction of the orbit and information concerning the direction of rotation of the shaft. So the direction of rotation is denoted with this arrow here to determine whether our shaft is in forward precession or backwards precession. And just a quick animation, forward precession is when the direction of rotation and the orbit are in the same direction. Backward precession is when the direction of rotation and the orbit are in the opposite direction. So we've got an extreme example here on the right where we're just showing forward precession, and then an example on the left showing forward precession, and then an example on the right showing backward precession. So here in this animation, the shaft and the direction of rotation are in the same direction. On the right, when we're in backward precession, the direction of the orbit and the direction of rotation of the shaft are in opposite directions. So let's talk about how we create a orbit plot. So I've got a shaft and I've got two proximity probes, and I'll plot the displacement versus time of each of these proximity probes. I can then also plot the X values and the Y values against each other. So here, once I start this animation, you'll see both a displacement versus time sine wave. And when I plot those two values together or against one another, I get a circular orbit. And what this circular orbit is kind of denoting is the path that the center of the shaft is traveling during one cycle or one rotation. If I look at that in maybe a slightly simpler way, I have a shaft that's going to be rotating. I've got a key phaser here in green and one in blue. And as the shaft is rotating, I can see the kind of path of the center line, which is the orbit of my shaft. And if I again just kind of show how this is plotted, you can see that this kind of this relative motion of the shaft center gives me my orbit plot. So on the left hand side here, I have what's called an unfiltered or a direct orbit, and this is just plotting unfilters or unchanged X versus Y values of my orbit through one cycle. I could filter that and include only the kind of the dynamic information that's related to things like the imbalance of the shaft. And I would get an orbit that looks slightly simpler, like this one on the right. And that might be useful if you want to compare only the imbalance across multiple points on your machine or between different machines, etc. So there's going to be occasions where it'll be really useful to only look at the vibration content associated with one times the rotor speed, two times the rotor speed, or at harmonics below the rotational speed. And here I've got just a couple of different orbit plots pictured just to kind of give you a flavor of what some of these orbits can look like. So a first order imbalance typically looks like just a circle or an oval. It might be slightly rotated, but it's typically kind of a standard circular type orbit. I have another elliptical orbit shown here, and this orbit would be due to either low bearing stiffness in the lateral direction, or you might have some restricting force in the y direction that's pushing down on the shaft and forcing it or not allowing it to rotate more in the y direction. If I have a large second order contribution, I get kind of a moon-shaped orbit here. And then for things like fluid instability, you get sort of, this is, I suppose, not all orbits or systems that have fluid instability will look like this orbit, but you might get sort of this heart-shaped orbit where the orbit kind of crosses back over on itself. All of these different orbits that are generated by looking at our data from our proximity probes give us some kind of clue or some information as to how our rotor dynamic system is behaving and what's causing that behavior. As a quick aside, we've shown in most of our animations our proximity probes placed in the 0 degree direction and the 90 degree direction, but different orientations are possible. So you could instrument these at 45 degrees and 135 degrees, which is kind of typically most common, or other orientations depending on the accessibility of your machines. You don't need to do anything in the software other than just indicate the direction or the location of these proximity probes, and then everything else is taken care of for you.